five specs that you have to look out for when you have to select any particular speaker. Hello everyone, I am Tanmay Mehta, your home technology consultant at Touchwood Automations, and today we are going to talk about five specs or five parameters or five factors that determine that what sort of speaker should you really buy. Now, as promised in our last video, wherein we discussed about various types of speakers, various categories of speakers, this particular video is like a part two version of it, wherein I am going to help you decide a particular speaker, because I know when you are out there in the market looking to buy a speaker, you are coming across so many brands that A, you have never heard of, and B, you don't know whether this brand is good or that brand is good, because obviously for you everything is new. And that's when what you do is you would go on a Google and look out for those particular brands or those products, and you don't know that how can I really understand the comparison between two speakers or between a variety of speakers. And for that reason, we are doing this video wherein I'm going to tell you that whenever you look for any particular speaker online, offline, or on their spec sheet or in their catalogs, what are the top five things that you have to consider or that you have to look out for, which will help you understand that what sort of speaker is the right speaker. Now, again, there's a disclaimer before I start doing this. These five things are something, as I said, are based upon a lot of other factors as well, like what is the material of the speaker, what sort of driver composition it is, what sort of tweeter it has. But apart from that, in terms of specs, these are the five specs. And before I begin with my specs, I want to tell you all to subscribe to our channel, because if you haven't done that right now, you need to do it, because your subscription encourages us in our mission to bring out more such valuable information based videos, which are helping each one of you in making better decisions when it comes to buying anything and everything of home technology industry. So I hope you have done that. Now, the first specs or the first factor or the first parameter that you have to consider when you are looking out for speakers in the market is the impedance. Now, impedance is calculated in ohms. It's like the resistance. I always tell people impedance for me is like a speed breaker. Because imagine, let's say you are driving a car and you are in a good speed of 100 kilometers per hour, and you come across a bump or a speed breaker. What would you do? You would reduce the speed, right? Now, the speed is reduced based upon the height of the speed breaker. So let's say if it's a small speed breaker, you would not reduce your speed too much. If the speed breaker is bigger, you would increase you would reduce your speed a lot. And that is exactly bump or that speed breaker is nothing but a resistance or an impedance in this audio industry. Now, ideal impedance that you come across in most of the home theater speakers is 8 ohms, 6 ohms and 4 ohms. So these are the three impedance or resistance that you will come across. Now, what does that mean is lower the impedance, higher the power will be drawn from the amplifier. So when you're buying a speaker, let's say if you're buying a 4 ohm speakers versus a 6 ohm speakers, a 4 ohm speaker would draw more power from the speaker and would also deliver more power. But for a 6 ohm speaker, it might draw less power from the amplifier and yet might deliver a better output too. So for instance, let's say a 8 ohm speaker, which is 180 watts, that can be equivalent to a 6 ohm speaker, which is 200 watts. That can again be equivalent to a 4 ohm speaker, which is around 220 watts. So that's roughly, how the ohms or the impedance calculation matters. So for a good home cinema system, you don't want to go down to 4 ohms, because you want that resistance to increase so that we don't draw more power from the amplifier. So an ideal investment would be in a 6 ohms or an 8 ohms speakers for a home cinema room, wherein you don't want too much of loudness. If you are in for loudness, then 4 ohms is something that can interest you, and you can decide to invest your money in a 4 ohm speakers as well. So once again, the first parameter is your impedance, which is calculated in ohms. Now, the second factor or the second parameter that you have to look out for when you buy a speaker is the sensitivity. Now, what is sensitivity? Like you and I, speakers also are sensitive to certain things. And what is that thing? It's the power. So for instance, what we mean by sensitivity in speakers is that when you give only 1 watt of power to a speaker and you stand at a distance of 1 meter and you hold a mic, the sound that comes out from that speaker is measured using your mic and that sound is calculated or is measured in a unit called decibel. I know you all would be familiar to this particular unit called decibel. So this same decibel is the sound output that is coming out from the mic, from the speaker, and that you are measuring in the mic, which is held at a distance of 1 meter. So let's say for a speaker which is giving you a sensitivity of 86 dB versus a speaker which is giving you a sensitivity of 89 dB or 90 dB. Now, what sort of speaker would you make a decision to buy? Well, the honest answer is higher the decibel or higher the sensitivity, better it is for the speaker, because that means that your speaker is going to draw less power, yet it is going to deliver the same output that is required for other speakers for that higher power. So whenever you are buying a speaker, you have to check what sort of sensitivity does that speaker carry, and can you really, you know, go for a better sensitivity speaker. So 86 dB, 87 dB to 91 dB, these are approximately the specifications or the sensitivity of the speakers. Obviously, the professional speakers that are used, they start from 100, 105 dB as well. So that's the sound that comes out from a speaker even after giving only 1 watt of power, and when you stand at a distance of 1 meter. So that 1 watt divided by 1 meter is calculated in something called as decibel. So that decibel unit is the sensitivity of the speaker. So higher the sensitivity, better the speaker will be. Now the third fact or the third parameter that you have to consider before buying a speaker is the frequency response. So I think you all know, if you have seen our last video, we have already talked about this, that each speaker has a frequency response, which means that it can deliver a sound in that particular frequency range. It starts approximately from 20 hertz, 40 hertz, 50 hertz, and can go up to 20 kilohertz, 30 kilohertz, 40 kilohertz. So better the frequency response, better would be the output from the speaker. So generally for low frequencies, as I said, your satellites would start from, let's say, around 100, 110 hertz. Your bookshelf, in-wall, on-wall speakers would start from around 60, 70 hertz, and your floor standing would start from your 40 hertz. So these are the frequency range in terms of the low frequencies. For the high frequencies, they can go up to 20 kilohertz, 30 kilohertz, 40 kilohertz. So that the better the frequency response or the larger the frequency response, it's always better for the speaker. So that's the third parameter that you have to consider. The fourth parameter obviously is the power. Wattage as we know, or watts as we know. Now there are two types of watts. If you are actually comparing these kind of systems with any sort of Sony, Philips, Panasonic, well, then that is not the RMS wattage that we calculate about, because all these other systems, they sell their systems on a PMPO mechanism. But what we sell when we talk about 100 watt speaker, that 100 watts is nothing but a RMS value, which means that it is a root mean square value, and it's way more lower than what a peak power or a PMPO output would be. But yet the sound output that these speakers will deliver, which will be much more better than a PMPO speaker. So when you buy a speaker, what you need to check also is the wattage of the speaker. Now I know some brands have stopped mentioning wattage, and what they also mention is, instead of that, recommended power amplifier or recommended amplifier power, which means that whatever amplifier you connect, it has to be amongst that particular range so that it can drive the speaker. So whatever it is, that is also still a fair specification that you can compare to. But yes, power really matters, because higher the power, higher would be the output from the speakers. So power is the fourth specification, and the last specification, which is your fifth specification or fifth parameter, which is going to help you buy a speaker, is nothing but the dimension of the speaker. Because I know in today's environment, we all are particular about what sort of size of the speaker would be, whether it will go on the wall, how much outside will it come from the wall, whether I'm going to lose my floor space, if yes, then how much, what sort of height are we looking for. So all these things do matter, and certainly yes, when you're looking to design a good cinema room or good living room and you want to install the speakers in that. So in terms of matching the speakers to your aesthetics, it is very, very important that you look out for these things, like, you know, your dimension of the speaker, the depth, the height, and the width of the speaker. So that's the fifth parameter that you need to consider. Now, as I said again, that all these five parameters are based upon the selection of the speaker, but these are not just the only ones, because certain times you may come across that a certain driver based, you know, a driver composition material frequency response is less, but because of the driver being loud enough or that driver material being great, that speaker can be still great. So yes, that can happen. Also, based upon your aesthetic dimensions is not just the only factor, the color of the speakers can also be something that you have to consider. So these are 2-3 things that you need to keep in mind when you buy a speaker. But as I said, don't forget about the 5 parameters. The first one is your impedance, which is calculated in ohms. So higher the impedance, lesser the output, the power would be drawn, which is still good. Then the second parameter we checked was a sensitivity. So sensitivity is measured in decibel. So higher the sensitivity, better is the output. The third parameter that we checked was the frequency response. So higher the frequency response or the frequency range of a speaker, the better it is for a speaker. The fourth one is power. Again, higher the power, it is better for the speaker. And the last one was the dimension. Okay, now dimension, there's no higher, smaller, better, because that is purely based upon what sort of design you're planning to do. So these are the top five specification that you need to check when you are looking out for good speakers in the market and you are getting confused as to what should I buy. So that's it from my end. If you have liked this video, if you have found this particular video very, very informative, don't forget to hit the like button. Also, you can share this video with the people who are, you know, your near and dear ones who are out there in the market looking for speakers, because you might just have given them the right guidance that is required to buy a good speaker. So once again, I'm Tanmay Mehta, your home technology consultant from Touchwood Automations, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Thank you.